Yes, there are many, many more coming, but let's begin with this one. This is a really edgy look in which I have tried to incorporate like my favorite blue kajal. I used to wear this a lot when I was younger, but I never really understood how exactly to like, you know, put it on. I used to just take it and put it all over my eye, which was quite scary, actually speaking. Yeah. So, but then I saw this look on Pinterest and I really liked it. Like, you know, the whole from dark to light, it really has that pop shade. So, if you want to know how to do this look, which is super simple and you need like minimal products, then keep watching. I've already prepped my face with the Lakme CC cream and my L18 compact powder. First, we're going to start off with the eyes. Because in this look, I'm kind of concentrating on giving it that pop of blue. We're going to keep the eyeshadows really simple. So all I'm going to do is take a little bit of dark brown. You could use any color that's like your natural skin, but just a tinge darker. Take it on your ring finger and then just like apply it to your eyelid, like right in your crease. That's about it for my eyeshadows. Now I'm going to use a little bit of this highlighting shade for my brow bone. For the next step, because we're going to be really concentrating a lot on the lower lash line, I'm going to take a little bit more of my compact and kind of dab it on to the lower lash line. This really helps in kind of keeping your kajal on for a really long time. Really important part of this look, it's the winged eyeliner. I'm gonna be using a liquid liner because like I'm really comfortable with it, but you can use any kind of liner that you're comfortable with. So you draw a line towards your eyebrow end, and then you start connecting it from the middle of your eyelid and then fill that in. Kind of like a party look, I'm gonna keep the wings really big. You can keep it as big as you like. You know, if you want it to be more natural, then you can just give it a little flick. But if you want to go all out, then make nice big wings, because you're an angel, you deserve some wings. And now follow the same steps for the other eye. Easiest ways like that I do it is hold a mirror kind of below and look into it and then line it. And remember to keep the line towards the inside really thin and towards the out like all out. Okay, so once your eyeliner is done, now we move on to the main part of this look. So for this look, because we are playing around with a lot of colored kajal, usually I would use like a dark blue and a light blue, but because I cannot find my dark blue, I'm going to be using the Lakme Iconics Grey and this really beautiful bright blue by this company called Jordana. You could even try out VOV. They have some really lovely blue colors, and even the Lakme Iconic Blue, that you could use that too. Just remember that for this look, you're going to need a color that's slightly darker and slightly lighter, because the whole idea is to kind of make it blend into this dark to light shade, like a ombre, you know, ombre kind of feeling. So with taking the gray, I'm going to be lining the outer portion of my lower lash line. I'm not really concentrating on the waterline, but I'm concentrating on the outside. Now taking the lighter blue color, I'm gonna start applying that on the inner portion of my lower waterline. And I'm gonna connect it with the gray so that that will help me when I'm kind of trying to blend both the colors. Thank you. smudger kind of thing that you, this is something you usually get with all eyeshadow palettes. So I'm just gonna use this and I'm going to merge the grey and the soften the look, because it's like right now, like, can you see the difference? Like, this has, like, it's blended and this is like more harsh line. Now once you do this, you will notice that the lighter blue has kind of faded out, so you're gonna have to go over it again. And you can even use this on your inner waterline. This will help to give it that extra pop. Optional, but I feel doing this is going to help take your look to the next level. What I usually do is I have this eyeshadow palette which has a really bright blue. It's almost similar to my Kajal, but it's much brighter and it's really shiny and glittery. So all I'm going to do is I'm going to take this on my ring finger and I'm going to just put it right in the inner portion of my eye. Shiny for you, then you can just smudge it into the rest of your, you know, Kajal. But hey, it's party season, you can add all the sparkles you like and you'll look like a total disco ball. Now the last step, taking your grey once again, you are just gonna wanna connect the lower portion to your winged eyeliner. That's about it for the eyes. And now for the usual eyelash curler and mascara. You don't have to use an eyelash curler, but I just feel that using an eyelash curler really helps, especially if you're gonna be, you know, like partying for till the late hours of the morning. It's gonna really help to keep your eyelashes all up. And now I'm gonna be using my Maybelline Hyper Curl Volume Express Mascara. I absolutely love this mascara. Another tip for like absolutely having zero clumps in your mascara is really wiggling the brush, and like that, you will notice the difference. You will have zero clumps, literally zero clumps. Don't forget to put mascara on your lower lashes really lightly. Don't want to touch the lower waterline, because then the like your entire blue Kajal is gonna look all black then. So really lightly. And now for the rest of the face. So because your eyes are the main focus of this entire look, you want to keep the lips kind of nude. But what you could do is you could add a little bit of blush on your cheeks to kind of, you know, just give it a little bit more pop of color. The way I like to apply blush is kind of almost as if contouring my face. So I suck my cheeks in. So that's about it. Ooh, my gloss. Another way to make your lips really pop out is using the same shade you used to highlight your brow to highlight your Cupid's bow. You could also use the same highlighting shade along the bridge of your nose. Make it really appear as if you have a beautiful slender nose. So for the hair for this look, I feel that just having like a really sleek straight hair kind of look is gonna look really good. So I've kind of blow dyed my hair straight. And for the outfit, I would suggest maybe something like a nice plain dress with like a really chunky leather jacket, or maybe, you know, some really chunky accessories, because this look is really edgy and out there. Be sure to like this video if you like this look, and subscribe to my channel if you wanna see more New Year's looks, because I've got you covered, totally covered for New Year's. And be sure to check out my Twitter, Instagram and my blog, because I do product reviews, outfit of the day details, and it's gonna be a lot more awesome stuff. Yeah. So you can send me your video requests in the comment section below, and do check out the description box if you wanna know the products that I use. And see you in my next video.